I'm Nisha Garg and this is your own food channel. If you guys have been following me on my Instagram or in real life, you know that I have been searching for the healthiest options of food that we can include in our life as I was on a weight loss journey. So yes, I have bought for you guys as well something really unique and something that is catching all the food trends in the world now, and that is a Buddha bowl. Buddha bowl is inspired by the food that has been inculcated into the Buddhist form of life. So it includes a lot of fiber, a lot of protein, all the macronutrients and a lot of fresh veggies to make it a very healthy bowl so that you can dig it into everything healthy and take care of your diet. Today I am going to make a very basic bowl which is going to comprise of brown rice and a little of soya beans because it is a rich source of protein and vitamin B12 and also some veggies. So without wasting any time, let's just go to the kitchen and sort out Buddha bowl as fast as we can. So guys, for the Buddha bowl, I'm going to take a simple bowl here and put in some brown rice. Now this rice, I have just cooked it in a steamer and just added a little of clove, jeera, green chilies and of course coriander, because I love coriander in brown rice. So I'm going to form a base out of this brown rice as it's very healthy and it has a lot of fiber. So yes, this way I'm going to create a base of it. Now I'm going to add in protein, and for protein I am going to use soya bean curry. Now soya bean curry is very rich in vitamin B12 and I actually love soya bean more than paneer, so I am going to add in a lot of soya bean here. You can see that I have added a lot of gravy in soya bean because I did not want to make it a entirely dry thing. And now I am going to add in a lot of stir-fried veggies. These are greens, broccoli and a lot of carrots. Just stir-fried all of these in olive oil with a little of salt and pepper and it's all ready. Also, to add in a little light to my Buddha bowl, I am going to put in a born corn so that it just tastes nice. I love it. So this is how our Buddha bowl is going to be looking like: a lot of greens, a lot of protein and of course boiled veggie, so that we just have the proper nutrition for the day. And guys, of course you can add in a lot of fruits to make this work and I just love it. So guys, this is how exactly my Buddha bowl turned out to be. It's still hot, but it has brown rice which I cooked with a little of herbs like clove. I used jeera, or you call it cumin seeds. Also, I used a little of green chilies and all so that I get a lot of flavor. I put in a little of black pepper too. So that is there in brown rice. Then there is stir-fried veggies which I made out of olive oil, black pepper and salt, and I just kept on cooking them. There are a lot of greens, carrots and spinach and corn and a lot of veggies there. In the form of protein, I wanted to include soya bean and not just paneer or something like that. You can go for alternate options. I'll give you options in each category. And then for boiled vegetable, I just went for the corn because right now I'm having a lot of corn in the market. I just thought, let's put in something fresh here. So yeah, this is my Buddha bowl and now I'm going to taste. I can binge on it all day long. This is so comfortable. You just have to eat out of a bowl and it has all the healthy things. I love soya bean. I'm a soya bean fan. And this bowl, it has everything needed. A perfect bowl with only the natural and healthy ingredients which you can mix it in your daily life out of the general foods that you cook and make it really nice. I learned about Buddha bowl from one of my fellow bloggers, and I thought, why not just give it a try? And that is why I bought for you this one. Although you can change in the ingredients here. For example, if you do not like brown rice, you can always go for white rice. You can also go for rice noodles and just make your base that way. And then there is an important part of Buddha bowl, that is protein. In every Buddha bowl, there has to be an element of protein. So you can go for tofu, you can go for paneer, you can go for soya bean. You can also go for hummus or chickpeas, which are a great source of protein and vitamin B12. And then you have the stir-fried veggies. If you're not a fan of broccoli or carrot, you can always go for corns. You can always go for cabbages. You can always go for cauliflower. And you can also include avocados. I'm not really a fan of avocados, but I would still recommend it. You can go for cherry tomatoes. A lot of options are there in vegetables. You can also add in a lot of fruits in here. You can go for grapes. You can go for oranges. It's very in season. You can go for apples also. And it just mixes up with the whole thing and makes it really nice. As for the corn thing, I do like this bhutta, they say, or you can say the corn stick. I really love it boiled, so I just added up it whole and made this Buddha bowl for me. Buddha bowl is the next big thing to try if you want to go healthy and tasty at a go. Make your own version of Buddha bowl each day, and I'm sure you get to see yourself in a much, much better way. Buddha bowl is something that I highly recommend, and that is why I brought to you a very simple thing. Do let me know if you want to go for more recipes for Buddha bowl, because this one was a very basic one and I would love to share more of it. Guys, if Buddha bowl intrigues you and if you give it a try, then do share it with me. What was your take on it, or how did you assemble your Buddha bowl? As for me, I'll just take a leave and wait for you guys to share your own inspirations or healthy things that you do in life to keep yourself better. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends, and also share your views with me so that I can come up with something new each time. Till then, I'll see you on the other side. Bye.